Hey everybody, welcome to another episode of the Netflix. We are still at the Build Conference here in Seattle, and we are talking to Dan Wasnova. Hi Dan.
Hi.
Thanks for taking the time.
My pleasure.
So you're a program manager on the Azure Messaging front, right? Or program manager lead?
Yes, I'm responsible and product owner for all of Azure's messaging services. Okay. So that would include Event Grid, Service Bus, Event Hubs, and Relay.
Okay, so IoT Hub is another team, or is it
that
something
is a sister team?
Yeah. Okay, cool. So Event Grid, can you explain a little bit for those who haven't heard about it yet, what it does and when do you use it?
You bet. So Event Grid is a notification or eventing platform that we built into Azure, natively into Azure, to give you push notifications that you can subscribe to on any resource in Azure, and even things outside of Azure.
Okay.
And this is a little bit different than some of the other messaging we do, like something like Service Bus, mm-hmm. where Service Bus is sort of traditional enterprise messaging, pub/sub, where I'm basically telling you, hey, here is something. I am telling you something.
Yeah.
And Grid is more like you just coming and tapping me on the shoulder and say, hey, come tell me when something happens.
Okay.
So you're really, whereas something like Service Bus and something like TIBCO or IBM MQ is focusing on the producer, mm-hmm. we're here more just focusing on the subscriber.
Okay, so and it's really push-based.
Yeah, and it's push-based. It's tied into almost every Azure service, and it will be tied into every Azure service. And we released our Cloud Events support last week so that now it can cross clouds as well and be compatible with other cloud providers and other tool creators.
Okay, so are you the first to do this, the Cloud Events, or are there cloud providers as well already doing this now?
We are the first to put it in our product, I can say that.
Okay.
It came in very hot. We've been working for a long time in the CNCF, and actually not that long, come to think of it. It just seems like a long time, but it's all been very quick this year, working in the CNCF to make this an open standard that everyone can agree to. And somehow, in a matter of months, we got like 30 companies to agree to it, and I think we just happened to land the first one. I'm sure others will be within days.
Yeah. And then those are not cloud platform providers per se, but also SaaS providers, I guess?
Yeah, you get both. You get cloud platform providers, you get SaaS providers, and then you actually get some that aren't even cloud, that are just sort of vendors of software tooling and of server products.
Right.
So you can think like, I would imagine serverless thing will be doing something that's very good for the gateway.
So, and when you're talking about other services supporting Event Grid, can you give some examples about the types of events that they can send to Event Grid?
Yeah, so today the big things that are happening for Grid are that we get new producers for events, things like media services is a brand new one, so that they're able to send out events when things are happening in media services, like file encoded,
okay.
things like that, and they're letting you tie together your sort of media distribution
right.
stuff in a much more serverless or much more cloud-native sort of way.
Yeah.
Another one that just onboarded was App Service. Now you can get events and notifications about things happening in your app service. And these are different than like Azure Monitor, which is logging and more everything that's happening.
Mm-hmm.
And these are specific events you're interested in because maybe you want to know when someone scales the app service, or maybe you want to know when this video is encoded so that you can actually start serving the video and
right.
other things.
So these are kind of like the real meta events. So if I compare this to like IoT Hub, get an event like something happened at your IoT hub,
but
I wouldn't route my whole telemetry stream to the event.
Absolutely. I mean, that's not really the intention. The intention is that a perfect example for IoT hub would be like device registered.
Yeah.
So
right.
if the device is registered, well, you probably want to fire off some other stuff. Or for instance, like you might want to turn off my badge, on my last day at work, and you can have that, hey, turn off Dan's phone too.
Yeah.
So device unregistered.
That's a good one. That's one we always see. The deprovisioning processes at our customers are not always.
Yeah, everyone thinks about provisioning, and a lot of people don't think about it.
Yeah, right. So, any other cool news about Event Grid?
Yeah, so a lot of cool stuff for Event Grid this week. We actually just rolled out support for storage cubes, Azure Storage Cubes, as a destination for Event Grid. So, part of the whole idea with Event Grid is you get routing, intelligent routing, and you get push. But sometimes you don't actually want push. Sometimes you want a queue. And storage queues is a good, simple queue. And we made it so you can have your subscription in Event Grid be a storage queue. And what's really cool about this is now you can have pub/sub with filtering and storage queues.
Yeah, and then you can process them you're pulling away, you're ready for
absolutely,
it.
Absolutely, because at high scale, usually using a queue is easier than using HTTP push, although we have some improvements to make that better too. And the other thing is that sometimes you might want maybe a queue per user, and you don't want that user to have to be online to receive something or have the 24-hour retry window.
Yeah.
So that's a pretty cool one. Really useful. We're excited to see it. It's really more cloud-native upsell messaging.
Yeah, yeah.
And now you can start to see, as the cloud progresses and matures a bit more, rather than having like big monolithic services, you're really getting composable components like grid and storage queues that work really well together. So we have some other cool stuff that came up. We actually have policy for retry. So that our default policy was specified in our documentation about how we're going to retry and what order, an exponential back off, over 24 hours. Well, now you can use policy to set how do you want that retry to work.
Okay.
And maybe you don't care after 1 hour or after 30 minutes.
Yeah.
Some events just aren't valuable anymore.
So or retry fast or slow.
Exactly.
So trade-offs that you do to make sure that, okay, I want to be able to get every message, and sometimes you don't care after a certain amount of time anymore.
Absolutely.
If you want to get everything, then you also have to trade off something because you need to keep it somewhere and all that kind of stuff.
Yeah.
It's one of my choices. So.
Yeah. Because after 24 hours, that whole retry mechanism is done, right? And then the message is dropped?
Well, it was until this week. And we actually have, I'm not 100% sure when this will be launched, but I've used it myself and I know
it's CLI. Running somewhere.
Yeah,
it's running on your laptop.
The CLI supports it. It's running in our dog food environment. I did it last week, and the CLI supports it now. That you can actually specify a dead letter of your own for your subscribers. So that's a storage, a blob.
Not a storage queue?
Yeah, it's a blob.
Okay.
And we will write a bunch of the events to that together to that blob. Because when we're doing that retry, we're already in like a 1 hour retry window at the end of the 24 hours.
Yeah.
So we probably have a lot of them. And we'll just batch them up and throw them in this one big JSON in that blob.
Okay.
Yeah, so that's an exciting one to try out between policy and dead letter and storage queue. I think we really expanded the reach of what you can do.
And are there any further plans to maybe go to service bus queues and not just support storage queues?
We probably will go to service bus queues mostly because people are asking for it. It's something that kind of confuses me a little bit because service bus has all these rich, amazing features like transactions and ordering and all these things, but there is no ordering in grid. So.
Yeah.
I mean, I guess you can have order after it gets in the service bus queue, but you can't control what order it gets there.
Right. You get a random order and stay with it. But
you can stay with it. Yeah, exactly. But we'll probably be doing that. And one thing that we did already was turn on service bus as a source for grid so that you don't have to be pulling service bus for a long time. So it does make sense to make it a destination.
And we just saw a session of yours that you talked about event ups and Kafka in particular. So there were some cool announcements there.
Yeah, there were. That one was that was a fun one we've been working on for a very long time, and that was turning on Kafka. We're calling it Event Hubs for Kafka Ecosystems.
Okay.
Turning on a Kafka endpoint within Event Hubs. So the service is still Event Hubs, but the protocol is Kafka 1.0 and later, and it's binary compatible.
Yeah.
So my favorite parts of that session. Other than the Star Wars reference, which everyone seemed to like.
Star Wars ASCII art, even. So
yes, totally.
Really cool.
A big win there.
Yeah.
Is that those were Kafka tools, not special tools. So literally change the configuration and connection strings, and you're off to races.
Yeah, it reminded me a bit of Cosmos DB, where you can choose a MongoDB API and then use the regular Mongo tools to it.
Imitation is the most sincere form of flattery, and we're certainly looking at what the Cosmos DB team is doing because they're doing a great job.
Yeah. And that's just a flag to turn on in the portal, right, if you want that support.
Yep.
Cool. So any other cool things at Build for you this week?
Oh, there have been a lot of cool things. I've been really happy to see some of the IoT stuff. There were actually some announcements that I'm not going to talk about too much, but since Scott and Satya did, they have with Grid Edge and things like that.
Yeah.
So they're cool and worth looking at. Look at their keynotes, not me, to find out what's happening there. And there have been a lot of cool things happening in the data space, too. I've been really impressed by that stuff, by the database, and seeing how we really have a lot of. In the past, there were silos of stuff coming along, but now they're really becoming connected.
Uh-huh.
And the way that you can use, actually, we have a session with integration tomorrow, and you can use things like Logic Apps, with Service Bus, or Grid, and and like Cortana for analytics, and it's like, wow, you're taking stuff that I used to charge people a lot of money to do when I was a, when I owned a consultancy, and now it's like click, 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 it just runs.
Now I just need to make the correct choices of where to use what.
Yes, and that's the big myth that people need to be aware of. It's not like the jobs of figuring that out are gone. They're just different. So you're not going to focus on the infrastructure level as much, but you have to know which tools to compose the right way to solve the problem that you're trying to solve.
That's pretty often a more difficult job. So.
Yeah, it is.
So thank you very much for your time.
Thank you
very
much.
It was
very
nice talking to you.
You as well, thanks.
I hope you enjoyed it too. And I hope you also watch all of our other build videos. We are here all week, so we've got a couple of videos coming up. And see you soon.
Bye-bye.
Bye-bye.